Hello, everyone. Today, I will be playing a game called Universe Sandbox. It's basically, it's a universe sandbox. So, you can change, you can change how many seconds go by every, second, I guess. you can get more objects. It's just a game where you're basically a god and you control the universe. So, in simple form, so currently this is our solar system, and it is very large, the furthest orbiting object being Sedna. You know what? I have to disagree with that, because Planet 9 is actually a further away planet. It orbits about this far away. It orbits really far away, and somehow the sun keeps it in orbit. It's like a soccer ball keeping a pea in orbit. And yes, I did get that from Mark Grober. And at this scale, every object you see is basically like all the other stars, which are light years away, or the distance light travels in a year. So let's go back to the solar system. Let's go to specifically Earth. Okay. So this is the place where every single animal, every single human, every single living thing we've ever known, this is where they live. Every single one of them. Trillions of animals. Thousands of species. All here. On this little marble. So, to put into scale, just to put into scale, you think the sun is big. Well, this is the largest star. This is the largest star. It's huge. And not as insanely big, but our sun in 3 billion years. It is massive. So, and for scale, this is the observable universe. 93 billion light years. Not kilometers, not miles, but light years. And just so you know, that is about this big. This might take a couple of seconds, because it's literally that big. Literally so big. That down there is our puny solar system compared to the observable universe. And the entire universe is trillions of times larger, which is absolutely insane to believe. Let's zoom in. Scale, the solar system is just one dot. One single dot. And the furthest orbiting planet? You can't even see where it orbits yet. Oh, now it's the is how large the observable universe is. Very large. Now, let's go to Earth. Let's go to Earth. And you know what? Let's just throw the asteroid that killed the dinosaurs at it. Let's launch it. And it hit in southern Mexico, so more specifically right here and at an angle. So it hit about there. So let's reenact the asteroid that killed the dinosaurs. If you were orbiting the Earth on the ISS, which is about 400 kilometers above the surface, this is what you would see. That is what you would see when the asteroid, more commonly known as Chicxulub, I don't know how to pronounce it, but I think that's how you do. Yeah, that is what you would see, which is insane. Mexico and the United States and parts of Costa Rica, Panama, and that place, the Caribbean, yeah, they're just done. And it's about to come to South America. So, yeah, that's done for. You know what? And just for fun, not 4 billion years ago. A really long time ago, there was an object called Theia. Now, Theia was about the size of Mars, and it was a planet orbiting the sun as well, back when Earth didn't even have life. If this impact never happened, none of us would be here. History would be changed as we know it. Okay, that is not what happened. Here, let's get a new sandbox. Let's get an empty one. Just an empty sandbox. Let's get the Earth. And let's put it right there. Now, before it freezes, because there's no sun, let's slow time down. Theia was traveling towards it incredibly fast, but it wasn't a head-on collision. It was a side swipe. So, there. So it hit, and it knocked Earth clean into a new orbit. Clean. Now, at the current speed, it to be going super fast. It was traveling about that fast, which is insane. Wait, we need to rename it. It's not Mars, it's Theia. Alright, Theia. So there it is, Theia blasting towards the Earth. Directly at it. Yeah, I'm sorry. It looks like Greenland and the North Pole and some parts of Nunavut are gonna take the brunt of the impact. Rest in peace, Earth. I'm just kidding. Life will still exist beyond you. Are you kidding? It didn't even hit. Okay. My aim is literally terrible. Look at that. It didn't even hit. Alright, that's just sad. Let's fix that. Alright, we need to... That is just sad. Okay. That is just sad, though. I can't believe that happened. How did that just happen? And yes, to all you flat earthers out there. To all you flat earthers out there, the earth is not flat. It is not flat. It is round. Alright, that should be good. Sideswipe. It wasn't a direct impact. It was a side. It did a lot of damage, though. And keep in mind, Earth did not look like this before. Oh my god. It's getting hotter than the inner core of the Earth. It's like, oh my gosh. At one point, Okay. I did not expect that much damage. Okay, Earth is turning into a star in its own right. It's turning into a star. Oh my gosh. A blue dwarf. It's a blue dwarf. Oh my gosh. Thea's a blue dwarf as well. 72,000 degrees. 72,000 degrees Celsius. That is literally hotter. That's like... Okay, for reference... That's just so hot, I can't even speak. For reference, the hottest temperature that your oven can get to, it's not even 500 degrees Celsius. Not even. And meanwhile, the surface of the sun is 5,000 degrees Celsius. The core of the Earth is 6,000 degrees Celsius. And the blast of a nuclear explosion for a brief moment doesn't even hit 30,000 degrees Celsius. That is how hot this is right now. It's literally giving off gamma rays. That's how hot it is. Oh my gosh. Well, didn't expect that. Alright, let's get rid of those. And what's the temperature of the debris? 11,000. 17,000. 17,000. 200,000. 200,000. Look at that. The bottom right. 200,000 degrees Celsius. Oh my gosh. Okay. Yeah, but temperatures can still get a lot hotter. That is insane though. 200,000 degrees Celsius. What? 970,000 degrees Celsius. That is insane. 1.1 million degrees Celsius. 1.1 million degrees Celsius. The outer corona of the sun doesn't even get that hot. It only gets to 1 million. And the inner core of the sun gets to 15 million. That is an insane temperature. Oh my. How do things even get so hot from one collision? Jeez, that is ludicrous. Is there anything here? 1.1 million degrees Celsius, though. That is just crazy. It just disintegrated. Oh, it's still there. That isn't even... Oh my gosh. And it's... Oh my gosh. Alright, I guess I'll end it there. Like and subscribe if you want to see more crap like this. Thank you for listening to my nonsense. These insane temperatures and insane sizes are incomprehensible to any object or any machine, any brain for that matter. We can cross the observable universe with observable universes. Oh my god. Alright, I'm gonna end this here before things get a little too out of hand. Thank you for watching. Comment down below if you want to see more stuff like this, and I'll see you guys in the next video. See you guys.